Hi, I'm Rick, and I don't want to talk to you about your car's extended warranty. Back in 2013, the Sony Vaio SVF series launched, and I picked up this at the end of the year, right before Sony sold the division off. One of the first laptops with a 1080p screen, it served me well after we swapped the default 500 gig for a 1 terabyte hard drive, but with current PCs able to hit the desktop in 20 seconds, thanks to NVMe drives, it's sure feeling sluggish. And a warning, before you attempt any drive swapping, always back up your data. Today we'll look at how we sped up this laptop and what you need to watch out for to speed up yours and some easy migration software. You know what works well out of the box without any software? Our sponsor, Noctua. Noctua's Redux Edition offers premium case cooling with industry-grade hydro bearings and Vortex control blade tip notches for supremely quiet and exceptional long-term operation, and they won't break the bank. Check them out at the link below. Lock screen boring? We made one. Free download, link in the description. After updating all the PCs in the studio to the latest Windows 10 release, this sucker was the last one to finish, taking almost 3 hours. I mean, that speaks more to Windows Update's inefficiency rather than the actual PC, right? By the way, don't forget to give us a quick follow on social media and subscribe and bell, all that good stuff. And if you tried your own upgrade or have questions, please let us know in the comments. So we're swapping out the current mechanical hard drive for a new SSD drive. And even if your laptop doesn't have SATA 3, even with SATA 2, you'll still notice better response times. Plus, solid state is more reliable than mechanical and makes less heat, is a bit quieter, and you'll get a bit better battery life. Laptops before about 2011 without SATA 3 won't get the same massive speed boost we see in this episode though. And buyer beware, SSD manufacturers often say, this drive can read and write up to 520 and 480 megabytes a second. But that speed has often been only the top model in, say, a 1 terabyte, 500 meg, and 250 meg lineup. Recently, this has gotten better, but check test reviews on the drive that you're looking at and be wary if the SSD speeds aren't listed. Okay, let's talk about return on investment. Are you just throwing money away? Is the cost of upgrading an old machine worth it versus getting a new one? With the silicon and GPU shortage still going on, it's probably worth it to ride this one out and get something newer or at a more reasonable price in the future. Before you do, there's three key factors. First is the CPU. This one's an i5-4200U, 2-core, 4-thread at 1.6 GHz to 2.6 turbo. For 2013, it was pretty decent, and it's still fine for doing Word and web tasks today. Though if you have a Celeron, Core i3, or CPU without double the threads, maybe pass on this upgrade. Second is your laptop's battery life and your use case. Replacing batteries can cost $100 and up even with a mass-produced model. After about 5 to 7 years, this battery doesn't charge anymore, useless to take on the road. But we're often using the laptop around the studio, and it's always plugged in when we need it, so we're good there. Since older PCs generally have no NVMe, the third key is the drive interface. We can check this using Hardware Info 64 summary only, and in the bottom left, we can see connected drives and the interface with our system. If you have SATA 1, you'll see 1.5G for gigabits, which transfers at 150 megabytes a second. If you have SATA 2, you'll see SATA 3G, which does 300 megs a second, and SATA 3 appears as 6 gigabits, transferring it up to 600 megabytes, and we're in luck here. So our current interface can do up to 600 megs a second. A quick baseline test with Crystal Disk Mark shows the hard drive is capable of read and write speeds just under 100 megabytes a second, the physical limitation of most mechanical laptop hard drives. And you need to check the drive to see if it's standard SSD size, mini, or some weird custom design. Most laptops have a panel for the hard drive. This hard drive is a standard 2.5 inch, and SSDs are the same size, sometimes thinner, which shouldn't be a problem. Mini SATA SSDs are costly, so look for a 1.8 inch SATA to mSATA adapter and an mSATA SSD. After checking the drive would fit, we first checked test reviews, then ordered a Samsung 870 Qvo 1 terabyte SSD with a rated 560 read and 530 write speed, and they're going for 120 on Amazon, on sale for 100. We tested this and got 564 read and 536 megabytes for write. Nice. Now we could just slap it in there and go through the hassle of a fresh Windows install. But what if there was an easy way to migrate your system over? We did a bit of research and heard that a program called Disk Genius was easy to use, and we saw user reports of success migrating hard drives to SSDs. And it worked for us also. We needed to prep the drive though. Past experience with other programs cloning full drives has taken hours with not great success, and we wanted to give Disk Genius a quick try. Since we had the files on here double backed up, we dumped those 260 gigs, removed unused programs, and a disk cleanup ran cleanup system files, taking out a 20 gig windows.old folder from the last update. Please take a moment to hit like, get subscribed, and click the bell. It supports us, and you'll get notified of our latest videos and reviews. Time to migrate the system. On a desktop PC with the power off, connect the SATA power and data cables to both the old hard drive and new SSD. Then, powered on and in Windows, we installed Disk Genius and launched it. Under Tools, there's System Migration, and we chose the old HGST 1TB SSD. Next was the target disk, the Samsung 870 Cuvo. Our drives are both 1TB, but you can adjust the free space on the drive. We didn't pick to change the computer boot sequence as it's not this computer, but the laptop. OK to continue, we chose hot migration, and it took a hair under 39 minutes to complete with an average 60 megasecond transfer speed. Power off, we connected the Samsung SSD in the laptop and turned on the power, and it worked the first time, everything the same as the other drive. I'm actually really surprised. My past experience with cloning, it ends up being a huge time sink, and I still end up having to do a fresh install of Windows. So Disk Genius, you just saved me hours, thank you for that, and we'll throw the link in the description for their walkthrough. Bad me, I was too eager to see the new SSD in action. After migration, the old drive still worked, then we confirmed the SSD worked, but then the old drive no longer worked. I don't know what happened, maybe the BIOS got confused with the swapping. Anyway, so we got this lovely screen, and yes, it took over an hour, but it wasn't done there, it failed. So we reinstalled Windows on the old drive to get that missing boot benchmark. 36 minutes later to the desktop, Windows updates finish at 1 hour, 34 minutes, but the CPU is still at 100%. The system became usable at the 2 hour 38 mark. Nope, wait, 2 hours 46 as anti-malware runs directly after all updates. Oh, Windows, you silly goose. Time for the benchmark, measured from power button press to stats showing in Task Manager. With the old hard drive, it took 40.4 seconds, and that's a fresh install, no programs. From memory, it was closer to about a minute. With the Samsung 870 Cuvo 1TB SSD, just 21.4 seconds, and we'll call that half. With 5.8 times the read-write speeds, it cuts boot time in half, and it feels snappier too. Wow, that's so much faster than it used to be. Overall, a great upgrade for 100 bucks, turning a slow laptop into something much more current gen. If you decide to grab an SSD for your upgrade, clicking through our affiliate links below to shop will help us here with no extra cost to you. And please do follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at TechSpinReview, and we have more at TechSpinReview.com. We have tech reviews on the channel, so be sure to check those out too. Good job to Samsung for making an excellent performing large budget SSD, and we look forward to new solid state storage from them in the future. And thanks again to Noctua for being our sponsor this episode. Their static pressure fans are perfect for cooling your rig, and you can check them out at the link below. So leave your best episode opening lines, and we might just pick yours next time. And we're interested to hear what you want to see reviewed, let us know and we'll try and get to it. Please take a second to hit like, subscribe, hit the bell, and let us know how we can improve. We read and reply to a lot of comments, so if you have a question or if we miss something, then please do tell us down below. And we really appreciate you watching this far. Thanks for your time, and we'll see you on the next. Bye for now.